स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल. एंड लेट अस सी द फोर्थ चैप्टर, द वॉल्स एड्रेस. दीज आर सम स्पोर्ट्स पीपल हु वॉन अ मेडल एट द रियो ओलंपिक 2016. नेम देम इफ यू नो अबाउट द, यू कैन नेम देम इन योर बुक. एंड दिस द राइटर इज गोइंग टू टेल अस अबाउट द ग्रेटेस्ट क्रिकेटर. Sir Donald Bradman, an Australian cricketer, is acknowledged as the greatest batsman of all time. The Bradman Orinchan, it's a speech, established in the year 2000, is an annual event honoring his memory. Every year, a prominent sports person is invited to speak, to say some words about the Mr. Sir Bradman's cricketing spirit and on the influence of the game in their life. Here is an excerpt. Here is an excerpt from the 2011 speech delivered by the speaker chosen that year, Rahul Dravid, the great man of the 2011. Now see, this is the chapter related to a great cricketer, Donald Bradman. Sir Donald Bradman, who was an Australian cricketer, it acknowledged as the greatest batsman of all time. He well known personality to the cricket world, the Bradman Orientation. Orientation, it's the speech about and say some words about their great spirit to the game. 2000, and in annual event honoring his memory, in the respect of his great memory, every year the prominent sports person, the great main leading sport person, is invited to speak, to say something about the Bradman's cricket and cricketing spirit on the influence of the game in their life. What is the great role of they are in this game? And here is an excerpt from this 2011 and a speech delivered. It is in 11, the speech was delivered by the great cricketer, Mr. Rahul Dravid. See the part of the speech. Thank you for inviting me to deliver the Bradman Orientation. The respect and the regard that came with the invitation to speak tonight is deeply appreciated. The Rahul Dravid, feeling the grateful and being the thankful to invite him to deliver the speech on the Bradman's Orientation. And that it was really very great respect and regard that came with the invitation to speak tonight. Deeply, he was feeling very appreciated, deeply appreciated, who has invited who. The picture is showing here the Rahul Dravid at the test match, and he was inviting for the delivered the speech about the Bradman. I must say that I find myself humbled by the venue that we find ourselves, even though there is neither a pitch in the sight, not some stumps or bat and balls. As a cricketer, I feel I stand on a very sacred ground tonight. When I was told I would be speaking at the National War Memorial, he was feeling very grateful to the, he was invited for the delivered to speech about the Bradman Orientation, and he is feeling very deeply respectful and appreciated by everyone. And he said that he must say that he finds himself very humbled and pioneered by the venue to find ourselves where he was standing. It's a great ramp, a great place, even though there is neither a pitch, there is no pitch, ball, bats and stumps, but it's a great stage to deliver these great words about a great cricketer, so that I feel I stand on a very sacred ground. He feel a very sacred, pious feelings to this ground. He respect deeply the person and the game. I feel I stand, he said that he's standing on a very holy ground tonight. When I was told I would be speaking, when I came to know I would be going to speak at the National War Memorial. It's like speaking about the National War Memorial. I thought, how I often to be meaninglessly the words war. He thought of how often and how meaninglessly the words war, battle and fight are used to describe cricket matches. It's a really very shameful thing to use this type of words for the cricket matches. It's just meaninglessly. He thought many times how often and how meaninglessly the word Words like the war, battle and fights are used to describe the cricket matches. It's not a match, it's just like a war between the country. So that see, yes, the cricketers devote the better part of our adult lives to being prepared to the platform, perform for our countries and to persist and the compete as intensely as we can and more. Yes, cricketer completely devoted to their country and to their games. The maximum time of their lives and adult life, they are prepared to perform gratefully to for the countries and to the game and compete very intensely, deeply that we can, that they can, and more. This building, however, recognized the man and woman who lived out the words, war, battle, fight, and people outside the people, outsider peoples. This building recognize the man and woman who lived out the words war, battle, fight for real and then gave it all for their country. Their lives left incomplete future exchange. And another outside of world people using these words like fight, war and battle, like these words, then future is completely denied. The people of both our countries are often told that the cricket is the one thing that brings Indians and the Australians together. The cricket is one thing who made togetherly at the same stage every world's people, the countryside. Every country was on the same stage, the only game in cricket. The India's the single common denominator. The Indians and Australians togetherly. The cricket is our single common platform. India's first Test series as the free country was played against the Australia in November 1947, the 3 months after our independence. The India's very important lies underline these. The India's first Test series as a free country was played against the Australia in November. That's the 1947, the 3 months after our independence, yet the histories of our countries are linked together far more deeply than we think and further back in time than 47. We share something else other than cricket before they played the test match against each other. They are sharing something else. It's played in the 47 and within 3 months they are linked to the independence. Yet histories of our country's independence in 47 and deeply think and further back in time there. And we share something else other than cricket. And we share there more than cricket. Before they played the first test match against each other, Indians and Australians fought wars together. What was the reason it's connecting with the independence? That's we share something else than the cricket. Before we played our first test match against each other, the Indians and the Australians fought wars together on the same side. The Gallipoli, where along the thousands of Australians over the 1300 Indians all lost their lives in the World War II. There were Indian and the Australian soldiers in the Al Malin, North Africa, in the Syria, Lebanon, campaigning in Burma in the battle for Singapore. Thus, the why we call the cricket as a battle. Now see, their lives in Second World War, and there were Indian and the Australian soldiers, even the in Almania, North Africa, in Syria, Lebanon, and the campaigning in Burma for battle for the Singapore. Thank you. Have a nice day.